everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 15.4 Beta 4. It's now available to developers, and hopefully by the time you're watching this video, it will be out to public beta testers as well. However, last week it came out the following day with Beta 3, so if it's not out a little bit later today, expect it tomorrow. Now, this update came in at 579.2 megabytes. That's on my iPhone 13 Pro Max, and it was between 400 and 600 megabytes on all the devices in this video, from the iPhone 6S Plus, iPhone 11, iPhone 10, iPad Pro, and 13 Pro Max. Apple also released iPadOS 15.4 Beta 4, watchOS 8.5 Beta 4, tvOS 15.4 Beta 4, and macOS 12.3 Beta 4. All of those are available to developers right now, and again, probably a little bit later to public beta testers. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings, then General, then About. You can see the build number is 19E5235A, and when we have an A at the end, that typically means we're getting very close to a final release. So I would expect a release candidate next, or RC, followed by a final release after that. I'll talk about when to expect that a little bit later on. Now, the first change they've made in this is a modem update. So there is a modem update. Prior to this, we had 1.59.00. Now we have 1.59.03, at least on the 13 Pro Max. So I really wasn't having any connectivity issues in this update between 5G, 5G UC, or 4G, or anything like that. But if you are, hopefully this will continue to resolve those issues for you. Now, the first change they've made, or feature that they've added, is if we go into Settings, and then we go down to Siri and Search. Under Siri and Search, go to Siri Voice. You'll see under American, we have a new option now for Voice 5. So this is something they've added in this update. Let me turn it up so you can hear it. So Voice 4 is typically what we have.
Hi, I'm Siri. Choose the voice you'd like me to use.
Voice 5 is a little different.
Hi, I'm Siri. Choose the voice you'd like me to use.
Listen to that one more time.
Hi, I'm Siri. Choose the voice you'd like me to use.
So you can hear there's a new voice option if you want to choose that. I did not find any other options under Australian, British, Indian, Irish, or South African yet. So maybe we'll have updates with that, with further updates with the release candidate or more. Now there's an additional feature or change when you pair an AirTag. So if you have an AirTag and you pair it to your device, what it looks like is this. So it says AirTag is linked to your Apple ID. Now it says AirTag is intended solely to track items that belong to you. Using AirTag to track people without their consent is a crime in many regions around the world. AirTag is designed to be detected by victims and to enable law enforcement to request identifying information about the owner. So that's just a new message that they've added with this update. And then within the update here, you'll see it gives you more information about precision finding, play a sound, and notify when left behind. Additionally, there's some new options for Find My under Settings. So if we go under Settings and we scroll down, we'll go to or scroll up to Notifications, scroll down to Find My, you'll see it just says Find My. If we look at Beta 3 or previous versions, it actually is a little bit different. So again, Notifications, go down, you'll see we have Find My and Find My Safety Alerts. You can no longer disable Find My Safety Alerts to let you know that there's an AirTag nearby. So they've made some changes there with additional customization within the Find My notification settings, so you can customize this how you'd like. So that's been updated in Beta 4. Additionally, under the Watch app, they've made some changes as well. So in Watch, if we go to Watch and then we go down to Mail, Find Mail. Under Mail, there's a new option for always load content directly. So this is applying to the watch. It will load it directly if you want it to. Also, you'll see here at the top where it says hide IP address. This is part of iCloud Plus, where you have to have it enabled if you have iCloud Plus to hide your IP for mail. Prior to this update, it did not hide your IP address on the watch, only on the iPhone. So now it will hide it on the watch, and you'll see it says hide IP address. If you turn it off under iCloud Plus, it will switch to show IP address. So that's something they've updated as well. There's also more code in here for Tap to Pay, setting that up under Wallet, where you're able to maybe have someone pay you via credit card, tapping the NFC chip on the back to pay you that way. So that's something that's going to be coming out with 15.4, it seems, but there is no option to enable that yet that I could find, but it should be in this update. Now there's also code changes within here. There's updates for notifications and captive Wi-Fi. And again, thanks to my friend Steve Moser for pointing that out to me and helping me find some of the things I've already mentioned as well. So you can see here, customize Find My notifications and some features and Find My require notifications. And then Apple is continuing to work on captive network support for Apple TV with new Bluetooth permissions copy for British English Bluetooth used for proximity setup. So you can see some of that code here as well. Now, as far as resolved issues in this update, there's only one that they mention in the notes, and that has to do with on iOS and macOS, it's possible to trigger taking a photo of a participant when in a group FaceTime call. They fixed that bug. You can no longer do that. Before, you could do that easily by tapping the bottom left corner of the screen, and on macOS, you could do that by tapping the right top right corner of the window. So that's something they've fixed in this update, and you shouldn't see. They haven't mentioned any other fixes, but in beta 3, we saw the storage bug seemingly be resolved. So I haven't seen that bug here. It looks like it's loading nice and fast. I went back in it, and it takes a second to load, but nothing like it did before where it could take 30 minutes. Or even longer, or just never load. You'll see it even loaded system data quickly. And most people are saying this was resolved with beta 3. If it's not, I would check it with beta 4, but it seems to be resolved for most people in this update if it wasn't in beta 3 already. Apple did not mention anything about the pink screen bug where it could go pink or purple and then reboot the phone. However, it does seem that they fixed it in beta 2 or beta 3, but again, they didn't mention it. Maybe they will by the time it's released. There's also no mention of the music bug where maybe you're playing music and streaming that music causes the CPU to be used a little bit more and then in turn causes battery drain. Again, they didn't mention that. However, they did mention 12 known issues, which is down from 13 the previous week. And there's a few notable issues, but they're basically the same as what was there before. One of them, again, being signing into an iPad is limited to apps in this beta. So there's some odd issues here and there that they're still aware of, that they're working on with health and more. As far as when to expect iOS 15.4 RC or release candidate, we could see that as soon as either the end of this week or early next week around Tuesday or so. That's typically what Apple does. And since we expect an Apple event around the 8th of March, which we would probably see an invitation either any day or probably next week at this point, it seems likely that Apple would release 15.4 to the public around the 8th. That will include new emoji and much more that's in this update. So a lot of different changes in this update, not only with Find My emoji, but there's some other nice things with Tap to Pay and more. Of course, there's that Face ID unlock with a mask as well included in this. So expect it within the next couple of weeks, an RC and a final release, and then we'll move on to maybe 15.5 betas. I did think we'd maybe have an iOS 15.3.2, but seeing how we're a couple weeks out from 15.4, that seems unlikely at this point. However, Apple did unsign 15.3 the other day, meaning that there should be an update coming very soon. So it's possible we see this earlier than the 8th, but at this point, that's kind of what I'm counting on. As far as battery life in this particular update, well, it will take a few days to know that, and I typically cover that towards the end of the week or on the weekend with a follow-up video, but battery life with beta 3 and 2 and earlier ones was not that great. My battery health on my 13 Pro Max is 100%, and if we go back to yesterday, you'll see I had 3 hours and 35 minutes of screen on time, 5 hours and 49 minutes of screen off time, and I used about 60% of my battery, 50 to 60%. So that's not great. I should be getting 10 to 14 hours of screen on time with this particular device. Again, today, if we go to today, even after updating, I only used 25% of my battery, but again, used 2 hours and 46 minutes of screen on time, 5 hours and 3 minutes of screen off time, and I've hardly used it. So it's using quite a bit in the background. Instagram is using a lot for some reason, and I'm not sure why, since I've hardly used it. So that doesn't make a whole lot of sense to me. Now, as far as overall performance, so far it seems good. On the 6S Plus, I tested it out here, and it seems to be performing pretty well. So just after reboot, it was fine, and you'll see this is the first time loading music. It takes just a moment here, and that's some of that has to do with Wi-Fi and pulling down the information, but it does seem generally smooth for what this device is. And then if we go into Minecraft, and I've talked to some of you about maybe showing a different game, but let's just see how it resumes. So we'll give it just a moment. RAM management, I would expect to be the same, but if we resume the game, that was pretty fast, especially on one of the oldest devices here, or the oldest device here, but one of the oldest supported devices, you'll see frame rates are nice and smooth. So that's really what we're looking for, and it seems to be pretty reasonable as far as overall performance. As far as benchmarks are concerned, I did run benchmarks on a couple devices here, but I want to save most of that information for the follow-up video, since we want to give it a few days for things to finish processing in the background. You'll see here for single core, I had 1,000 2,734 for multi-core 4,645. If we compare that to the weekend follow-up, you'll see it's a little bit lower, but when beta 3 released on the 15th, you'll see it's actually a little bit higher. So as long as we're within 100 plus or minus, it should be running just fine. But again, I'll show you more details about that in the follow-up video this weekend. The overall heat of the device, they stayed pretty cool after rebooting, so no issues there. It was nice and cool on all of these devices, which was a little pleasant surprise. Typically, they're quite warm. That shouldn't really affect much, but it's nice to have it sort of managing thermals a little bit better. And then that also leads me to, should you install iOS 15.4 beta 4? And typically at this point, we're at probably one of the last, if not the last betas until the RC. I would say you could definitely try it. Just make sure you have a backup. And of course, if you're on beta 3, definitely update to beta 4, since you'll have a better experience. Typically, you'll get more bugs worked out, and hopefully it's just performing and basically ready to release to the public. So I'll have more information about that as I know more about the update. So that's everything in iOS 15.4 beta 4. Of course, if I find more features, I'll have a new features video at the end of the week and a follow-up with all of the different things as far as stability, battery life, and more like I normally do on the weekend. Of course, if you've found anything else, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.